Brand new Valhalla items have leaked. I think it's a Helix set, but there are some interesting things going on with this pack. So want to go over that, and I also want to look at some new updates from Ubisoft on current issues and new things that they are working on for future updates. So a like on the video would of course really help me out. And let's go. There's still time to enter my recent weekly Helix credit pack giveaway by clicking the link in the pinned comment. And these giveaways are for subscribers of the channel only. I will announce the winner in the weekly reset video tomorrow and then reach out via the email. Maybe you already saw the interesting looking armor set in the thumbnail of the 2021 content video. I already wanted to tease you a bit. I know some people noticed it. Because yes, this is a new armor set that also has a lot of other items that will be coming to Valhalla at some point. And after the whole Gothic pack delay and then a release on Thursday, it's really hard to predict when we will see this. It's likely not gonna be this week or the week after that, so early February if I had to guess, although, again, anything can happen. But what of course matters the most is when these items will be available for Opal at Reda, and I followed up on a question from a week ago, like, I want, just like in Odyssey, that when a new item pack comes out, we can also get these items at Reda, that they are immediately in the rotation. This was the case in Odyssey, right now not in Valhalla. While Dom did suggest that the content is randomly selected from all available store items. So I asked this again and will report back when we know more. Because getting this new flag weapon from Reda will be amazing. Like, this is by far the highlight from this new pack. We see of course enemies use this weapon, but now we can get a flag as well. And shout out to Ooga Booga for recording gameplay with the new armor set on PC. He shared it via the input at drepta.com email address. Of course, if you got cool finds in the game, you can let me know there. And as always, I will also be using footage from Lexar's Games and Jonathan, and links to their channels are in the video description. So yes, it functions as a regular spear, but it looks of course way cooler than those regular spears, also when carrying it on your back. I really dig it, but the stats are not that strong. They are interesting though. You namely get a 15 attack when having a shield equipped. So that's pretty nice, a passive buff that you will just have active when using a shield. But that also means that when you don't use a shield, you will just not have a bonus from this spear, which kinda sucks. For one, you will need the heavy dual wield skill unlocked, otherwise you cannot even use a shield in the offhand with a spear. But I also think that dual spear is, for example, way better, as showed you in my previous best build video. But then this spear will not be of great use. Now it will just be cool to rock this when the visual customization system releases, so they can use a better spear for the stats while showcasing this cool flag. But yeah, as you already saw, this pack also obviously comes with a shield that is quite nice, giving you 5 speed for 10 seconds after one block. And I think it looks pretty cool as well with the crystals in the middle. And this whole set is about blocking and then getting a buff. Namely 25 attack and 15 speed if you have this full hardware armor on. But it's only for 3 hits. So not really that good. And I overall think that's actually great. Like, that Gothic pack feels almost too overpowered with how easy you can get health back and increase your attack in the process. This set is pushing you to play around the block, has some good bonuses, but only for 3 hits, after which you have to block again. So it seems way more balanced and kinda how I want the Helix packs to be, like that they push you to play the game differently while not being incredibly overpowered and easy to use. And maybe you already noticed it when looking at the chest here, but this almost identical compared to the chest from the Galloglach set, like, it's almost the same. So that's why at first I thought when it's leaked, maybe this is a reward for the river raids that we can get by doing this new activity that will be coming in February. Because it's also not that powerful, doesn't look over the top, and has a helm that also looks kind of bit like the Einar Jar set helm. So it seems more like the armor that we saw with the Yule Festival, right? That was also basically a variant of the Huntsman armor with some blood here and there. But no, it really seems that this is a new Helix pack that will come out at some point, because it also has a mount, a boring brown war horse, not really feeling it at all. The bird skin is pretty cool though, this huge eagle. So then you have only this and the flag as the true standout. So it will be really great to get these two items when they appear at some point at Reda. And now on to some other news, because right before the recent patch, we got Ubisoft updating their known issues page. And I saw many comments saying that some of the things that were noted in the patch notes were actually not fixed, like the quiver issue, where you have less maximum arrows, is still in the game for some people, or that the old cellar mystery can still not be completed. I saw some comments about that too. Community manager Dom already did note on Reddit that he will report this to the development team. And also interesting is that on Reddit he notes that that Ragnar cutscene that should be in the game after killing all the Drangir is still being looked into. I really want to hear an update on this. Let's hope that we can still get it at some point. And another similar video I did was on the Avenge quest that we do have some gameplay of, but overall never really appear. Well, now in the known issues page, Ubisoft says that they are looking into this. So confirming that it's indeed a bug that these missions are simply not appearing in the game, and that we will likely see a fix for it soon. So hopefully after one update, we can avenge more people in Valhalla. Also, if you are having trouble finding fabric anywhere in the game, I know many people are actually having this issue, then this should also be fixed in an upcoming update. When we know more about upcoming fixes and patches, I will of course let you know here. So totally subscribe to be up to date on everything Valhalla if you haven't already. There was a secret change regarding some Helix armor sets that are now made worse. I will talk about that really soon. I saw some people ask about it, so don't worry, we'll share my opinion on it very soon. A like on this video will of course really help me out. And at the end of every Valhalla video, we look at some awesome screenshots that you can send us via the Valhalla Raptor hashtag on Twitter, or by sharing it in our dedicated Pictures Discord channel. And you can join our Discord by clicking the link in the pinned comment. Okay, Joyce, the photo mod expert here on the channel, which pictures did you select this time?
What's up, everyone? So first of all, we're going to Crazy, who got inspired by a sudden glitch in the game with Eivor suddenly having wings. I mean, is Odin with us? What happened here? It did say in the tweet that it all happened because of yours favorite and best mount in the game, the Allspinder. This is what I would like to call, it's not a bug, it's a feature. And Crazy took the chance with this really creative shot. Second, there's light at the end of the cave with Wildman, who took this wonderful aesthetic shot where the power of Valhalla's world creation really shows. The reflection in the puddle on the ground there, and the shine on the walls from water splashes, I would assume, and then the ruins in the background. I really love this. And finally, DKTO98 took an Eivor selfie with the wolf companion you can, of course, get in the Men's Best Friend quest. This probably needed incredible timing, and I'm actually impressed by this, how photogenetic the wolf is here. Ubisoft, I'm looking at you, add some facial expressions for Eivor, and you're done. You got a perfect shot right here.
Yeah, Eivor should be smiling here too. Now it's kind of weird. But I do like how Eivor looks completely different here than, for example, my Eivor. So that's still nice touch. Thanks, yes. Joyce, as always. And we will look forward to more pictures in the next video. Of course, subscribe for way more Valhalla content, and check out our previous video about all the 2021 content coming to the game. For now, we will speak to you next time, and goodbye.
Goodbye.